Hello everybody. So today I will be checking out the live TV and PVR functionalities of both Kodi and Jellyfin and do a sort of a comparison. So I've got the Harpage Win TV Solo HD. This only has a single tuner in it, so you can only either watch or record one channel at a time. You can also get a two-tuner version of this same one, in which you can either watch or record two channels at a time. And of course, you can get ones that have even more tuners, but you'll need like a card for this. I don't think you can get one that has more tuners that works over USB. This one has four tuners in it, so you can record or watch up to four channels at a time. Now, in the past 5 years, Harpage have been really good about getting their code into the upstream kernel. So if you have a very recent kernel, TV tuners like this one should work out of the box on Linux. So, in order to get a PVR and live TV functionality on both Kodi and Jellyfin, we'll need some sort of backend. I like TVheadend. This works with both of them. And there are repositories for various Linux distributions. Now, my server is running CentOS, but the CentOS repository has not been updated in quite some time. However, the version in the repositories works very well. It's one I use, and I mean, it just works. I don't really need any later versions in this. I haven't found any deal-breaking bugs. So this is TVheadend. As you can see, it's got a nice web interface. My TV capture card's plugged into my antenna on the roof, and from TVheadend, we can actually watch TV directly from here. And we can also open these channels up with VLC if we wanted to. And this just plays the MPEG stream straight from over the air. It doesn't transcode it. So a quick overview of setting it up. You'll want to create some users. I've got some users for Kodi, some users for Jellyfin. Then here under DVB inputs, we get our tuner devices. So under networks, you'll want to click whichever network your country broadcasts in. In New Zealand, they use DVB-T. And then you want to do force scan, and that will scan for channels. And then they will get added to services. Now, it will probably find each channel more than once. So when we map these services, we can go map all services. Make sure you select merge same name because you don't want to have each channel more than once. And then here under channels slash EPG, we should get each channel only once. You'll have to manually add a channel number to each TV channel. And under recording, you will want to select your recording path. Under status, you can see which clients are connected and the usernames. Now, as I mentioned, you can only on each TV card, you can only watch so many channels at once, depending on how many tuners that card has. Mine only has one. But if you have any issues like watching a channel or recording, you can come to status and go to subscriptions. Make sure there's not something already using the tuner. So, I think Kodi does live TV and PVR a lot better than Jellyfin at the moment. Now, some skins are not very good for live TV and PVR. The default Kodi skin is very good for live TV and PVR, but some of the other skins you'll get, they didn't take live TV and PVR into consideration, and you might want to change your skin to back to the default one or find a skin that's ideal for live TV and PVR. So here under TV, we get channels, guide, recording, and timers. So we can go to channels and choose a channel to watch. such as Al Jazeera. And there we go, we get the channel. And it's not retranscoded or anything like that. Al Jazeera only streams in standard definition in New Zealand, so we'll try an HD channel, which is Māori television. They stream in HD.
Last few days, I remember all our kuia, they used to have a bottle of whiskey. They used to take it around.
As you see, it works very well. It's very fast at switching between channels.
The finished product, and this is so when you're in the rock pool.
Okay, so now let's check out the guide. So as you can see, the guide looks very nice. We get a description straight from over the air, which is actually retrieved from, again, TV Headend, because this is what it's connected to. So you'll need to enable the TV Headend plugin for Kodi. So if we wanted to record a TV show, we can select it and we can go record, and there we go. That will be recorded by TV Headend. So if we come back to TV Headend and we go upcoming current recordings, we can see one new special is scheduled to be recorded. This doesn't get transcoded, it just saves the MPEG stream from over the air. Go to finished recordings, we can see finished recordings. We can either play them here using VLC, or of course we could use Kodi. We can go to recordings and see that I've already recorded some TV shows yesterday. And yeah, did a good job, didn't fail. Now, a nice road trucker journey. Looks very well. Now, I recorded some shows back to back and on different TV channels just to test whether it would switch to the other channel in time to record the next show, and it did, so it works very nicely. Another great feature here in Kodi is we got our timers, and we can set up different rules. So we can say type, and we can repeat it, and we can do guide based, which is really cool. So we can say new timer, and we can say guide search for, so it'll search the guide for Family Guy, and we select the channel that it's on, TVNZ Duke, I believe. We can say any day of the week, any start time. We can prevent it from trying to record duplicate episodes. And you can set the lifetime, so 3 months. And as we can see here, it already found the next episode of Family Guy on Monday, 24th of August at 1 p.m. And if we come back to TV Head, we can see that it's indeed scheduled that. And if we go to the Auto Records tab, we can see here that rule has been set up. So it'll always record Family Guy if the episode number differs. Now, of course, when you're watching TV, you can also just come down here to the record button and you can record it. There's a bit you wanted to record. And then stop recording. If you leave recording on and exit out, it'll keep recording. So just be aware of that. And one of the cool things about this recordings screen is it tells you how much space you have left on the hard drive. Oh, you can't see it. Hold on. As you see there on the bottom right where my face cam was, it says I've got 2.4 terabytes left. So yeah, plenty of space left. That's quite handy. And from here we can also delete episodes. As long as the user that you use to connect to TV Headend has permission to delete, this should work. So, Jellyfin can also do live TV, as long as you got the TV Headend plugin. Now, the thing about Jellyfin's live TV thing is that it isn't as responsive as the Kodi one. But as you see, we get current programs that are on now. Of course, this is not all of them. We can go to the Channels tab and see all the channels in here. So we can try to play one. And it takes a while to start up. Now, this is because for some reason, Jellyfin is retranscoding the stream instead of direct streaming it. Now, Kodi can do direct streaming, but I think there's a bug somewhere now which prevents the direct streaming from happening. Now, as we can see, while we're watching this, I don't think there is a record button, so we can record from here. 50, 60 years ago when that rubbish can we stop the recording now? It just says recording scheduled again. Okay, I think it stopped. Yeah, it did. We can play that one we just recorded. No, it looks like it's still recording. Alright. How do we stop that? I think what's going to happen is it's going to record that show until the end. So what we'll do is we'll... Yes. So we can say stop from TV Headend. So the live TV and PVR functionality in Jellyfin is still not complete. They don't really have many developers working on live TV and PVR, but it does everything else really well. Additionally, I've tried live TV on the Roku, and you can watch live TV channels on the Roku, but you cannot do scheduling or anything like that. Now, I've also tried it on the Android app, and you can do scheduling and all that from the Android app. So if we go to the Schedule tab, we can see upcoming recordings. Yeah, and if we go to the Recordings tab, we can see previous recordings. So we can, for example, watch the Ice Road Truckers episode that I recorded. And we'll skip through some of it. Okay, so we can view the guide in Jellyfin too, and we can see shows that have been recorded are marked, and we can also tell it to record some TV shows. So as an example, we'll go down here, and we'll say to record this show. Unfortunately, we can't set up any timers or rules. The only way to record a TV show is to come in here and manually select them and hit record. So Kodi definitely does that better than Jellyfin at the moment. Anyways, that was a brief comparison of the PVR / live TV functionalities of both Kodi and Jellyfin. See you later, everybody.